Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 5.4. We are going to solve problem in the fluid dynamics and the flow meters. In the earlier lecture also, we solved a few problems from the Anna University question paper. And in this lecture also, we solve few more problems from the Anna University question paper on fluid dynamics and flow meters. Example number 11 from May 2006 question paper, a vertical density meter as shown in the figure carries a liquid of relative density 0.8 and has an inlet and the throat diameter 150 mm and 75 mm. The pressure connection at the throat is 150 mm above that at the inlet. If the actual rate of flow is 40 liters per second and CD equal to 0.96, find the pressure difference between inlet and the throat in newtons per meter square. And we are given specific gravity of the fluid which is flowing is 0.8, diameter D1, inlet diameter 0.15 meter, D2 0.075 meter, Z2, the throat position is 15 centimeter above the inlet. That is what given in the problem. The pressure connection of the throat is 150 millimeter above that at the inlet. So 150 millimeter is 0.15 meter. So Z2 equal to Z1 plus 0.15 and the Q equal to 40 LPS, CD equal to 0.96. So we calculate the area of the inlet and the throat section. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square. So 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square. 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.075 square equal to 0.0044 meter square. The head difference of the mercury column, we have to calculate the H value. So Q equal to CD into A1 A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So this is the discharge equation. So we are given discharge, we have to calculate the head difference. So discharge equal to 0.04 meter cube per second, CD is 0.96. A1 A2 0.01766 into 0.0044 divided by square root of 0.01766 square minus 0.0044 square into square root of 2 into 9.82 into H. So H is the unknown. So left hand side is 0.04, calculating all the numerical values 4.36 10 power minus 3 into square root of 19.62 into H. So calculating H equal to 4.29 meter. And the pressure difference between inlet and the throat. So, H equal to P1 by rho g from the Bernal's equation, P1 by rho g plus Z1 minus P2 by rho g into Z2 plus Z2 equal to H. So, P1 minus P2 equal to rho g into H plus Z2 minus Z1, rearranging all the terms. So, P1 minus P2, the pressure difference equal to 1000 into 9.81 into H equal to 4.29, Z2 minus Z2 equal to 0.15. So, this is 34,845 newtons per meter square. The answer is 34,845 newtons per meter square, the pressure difference between inlet and the throat. Example number 12 from May 2019 question paper, the inlet and the throat diameter of the vertically mounted venturi meter is 30 cm and 15 cm respectively. The throat section is below the inlet section at a distance of 10 cm. So, throat section is below at a distance of 10 cm. The density of the liquid is 850 kg per meter cube. Intensity of the pressure at the inlet and the throat are 150 kN per meter square and 90 kN per meter square respectively. If 4% of the difference in head is lost between inlet and the throat, find the volumetric flow rate. So here D1 equal to 0.3 meter, D1 is the inlet here and the upstream side. D2 equal to throat is 0.15 meter, Z1 equal to Z2 plus 0.1. So, the throat is below the inlet section. Density is 850 kg per meter cube. P1 equal to 150 kN per meter square. P2 equal to 90 kN per meter square. And the head loss equal to 4%. So, we calculate the area at the inlet and the throat section. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square. 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. Area, inlet and the throat section. And the effective head, you have to calculate the effective head from the pressure value given and the datum position. So P1 by rho g plus Z1 minus P2 by rho g plus Z2 equal to H. So substituting P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g plus Z1 minus Z2 equal to H. So substituting H equal to 150 into 10 power 3, 150 kilometers per meter square, 150 into 10 power 3 divided by 1009.81 minus 90 into 10 power 3 divided by 1009.81 plus 0.1, Z1 minus Z2 equal to 0.1, which is 6.216 meter. And the coefficient of discharge, so we are given loss of head to 4%. So from the loss of head we calculate the coefficient of discharge, CD equal to square root of H minus HF divided by H value 6.216 minus 0.04 into 6.216 divided by 6.216 equal to 0.98. So the coefficient of discharge equal to 0.98 and the volume flow rate equal to Q equal to CD into A1A2 divided by square root of A1 square minus A2 square into square root of 2GH. So substituting all the numerical values, Q equal to 0.98 into 0.07065 into 0.01766 divided by square root of 0.07065 square minus 0.01766 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 6.216 equal to 0.197 meter cube per second. So discharge equal to 0.197 meter cube per second for the problem. Example number 13, water flows at a rate of 150 liters per second through a 150 millimeter diameter orifice inserted in a pipe of 300 millimeter diameter. The pressure on the upstream and the upstream and the downstream of the orifice plate 175 kilopascal and 100 kilopascal. Determine the coefficient of discharge of the orifice meter. So this is from November 2010 question paper. So Q equal to 150 LPS. Orifice diameter is 0.15 meter, diameter of the pipe equal to 0.3 meter, D1 equal to 0.3 meter, P1 equal to 150 kilopascal pressure on the upstream side, P2 equal to 0.100 kilopascal on the downstream side. So area of the pipe and the orifice, A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square, A0 equal to pi by 4 D0 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square. The manometric head, from the pressure given, we have to calculate the manometric head. H equal to P1 minus P2 divided by rho g, 175 minus 100 into 1000. So kilopascal to pascal, we have to multiply by 1000. Divided by rho, density equal to 1000 into 9.81 equal to 7.645 meter. And the coefficient of discharge of the orifice meter. So from the definition of the orifice meter, discharge Q equal to CD into A1AO divided by square root of A1 square minus AO square into square root of 2GH. So substituting all the values, Q equal to 0.15, CD is the unknown, 0.07065 into 0.01766 divided by 0.07065 square minus 0.01766 square into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 7.645. So left hand side is 0.15, calculating right hand side the value is 0.2234, so CD equal to 0.67. Coefficient of discharge for the orifice meter is 0.67. Example number 14 from November 2013 question paper, find the velocity of the flow of oil through a pipe when the difference in the mercury level in a differential manometer connected to the two tappings of the Pitot tube is 100 millimeter. Take the coefficient of Pitot tube is 0.98, specific gravity of the oil is 0.8. This is from November 2013 question paper. So we are given x equal to 0.1, level difference of the manometric fluid is 0.1. CV coefficient of velocity is 0.98, specific gravity of the oil is 0.8. So the manometric head, H equal to X into SM, specific gravity of the manometric fluid divided by the specific gravity of the fluid oil which is flowing through the pipeline minus 1. So 0.1 into 13.6 divided by 0.8 minus 1 equal to 1.6 meter. Velocity of the flow of oil V equal to CV into square root of 2GH, which is 0.98 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 1.6 equal to 5.49 meters per second. So, the velocity of the oil is 5.49 meters per second. Example number 15 from November 2010 question paper. The Pitta tube is used to measure the velocity of water in a pipe of diameter 325 mm. The stagnation head is 2.2 meter and the static pressure head is 150 mm of mercury. Calculate the velocity. You take CV equal to 0.98. And we are given stagnation head HO equal to 2.2 meter, static head H equal to 150 mm of mercury and the CV equal to 0.98. So static head equal to 150 mm of mercury, which is 0.15 into 13.6. We have to convert into meter of water column. So it is 2.04 meter of water column. So dynamic pressure head delta H equal to stagnation head minus static head. HO minus HC equal to 2.2 minus 2.04 equal to 0.16. And the velocity of the water V equal to square root of 2GH. So put 0.98 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 0.16 equal to 1.74 meters per second. Velocity of the water in the pipeline is 1.74 meters per second. Example number 16, the question was appearing in November 2010, November 2013 and November 2019 question paper. A 45 degree reducing bend is connected to a pipeline. The diameter of the inlet and the inlet out and outlet of the bend is being 600 millimeter and 300 millimeter respectively. Find the force exerted by the water on the bend if the intensity of pressure at the inlet to the bend is 8.829 newtons per centimeter square and rate of flow of water is 600 lps. So we are given D1 equal to 0.6 meter, diameter of the pipe at the inlet, pipe bend at the inlet is 600.6 meter, D2 diameter at the outlet is 0.3 meter, pressure at the inlet is 8.829 newtons per centimeter square, which is 8.829 and 10 power 4 newtons per meter square, and discharge equal to 0.6 meter cube per second. We calculate the area of the pipe at inlet and the outlet, pipe bend at inlet and the outlet. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, so 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.6 square equal to 0.2826 meter square. A2 area at the outlet, pi by 4 D2 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. Velocity of the fluid at the inlet and the outlet, V1 equal to discharge divided by area A1, 0.6 divided by 0.2826 equal to 2.12 meters per second, and V2 equal to Q divided by A2, 0.6 divided by 0.07065, which is 8.49 meters per second. Applying Bernoulli's equation between section inlet and the outlet section, taking Z1 equal to Z2, P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g. Substitute in numerical value is 8.829 10 power 4 divided by 1000 into 9.81 plus 2.12 square divided by 2 into 9.81 equal to P2 by 1000 into 9.81 plus 8.49 square divided by 2 into 9.81. So solving this equation, we will get P2 equal to 54,497 newtons per meter square. And this is the bend. So at the inlet it is horizontal and it is 45 degree inclined at 45 degree to the horizontal. So at the outlet we have to resolve the forces. So V2 is the velocity, V2 cos theta is the horizontal component of the velocity, V2 sin theta is the vertical component of the velocity. Now the force in the x direction, so in the x direction, horizontal direction, Fx equal to rho q into V1 minus V2 cos theta. So V1 is the horizontal force here, and V2 cos theta is the horizontal component on the outlet, plus P1 A1 minus P2 A2 cos theta. So substituting 1000 into 0.6 into V1 equal 2.12 minus 8.49 into cos 45 plus 8.829 into 10 power 4 into 0.2826. So this is 8.829 10 power 4 is P1, A1 equal to 0.2826 minus P2 equal to 54,497 into A2 equal to 0.07065 into cos 45. So calculating, Fx equal to 19,898 newton. Then force in the y direction. So Fy, actually the horizontal, in the inlet the vertical component is 0. So Fy equal to pq rho into q into minus V2 sin theta minus P2 A2 sin theta. So 1000 into 0.6 into minus 8.49 to sin 45 minus 54,497 into 0.07065 into sine 45. So the answer is FO equal to minus 6324.5 Newton. Then the resultant force F equal to square root of Fx square plus FO square. So the square root of 19,898 square minus plus minus of 6324.5 square equal to 20,879 Newton. And the angle made by the resultant force theta equal to tan inverse of FY divided by Fx. So tan inverse of 6324.5 divided by 19,898 equal to 17.63 degrees. So the resultant force and the angle made by the resultant force are calculated in the problem. Example number 17 from November 2009 question paper. A 300 mm diameter pipe carries water at under a head of 20 meter with a velocity of 3.5 meters per second. If the axis of the pipe turns through 45 degree, find the magnitude and direction of the resultant force at the bend. So we are given diameter of the pipe is 0.3 meter, head equal to 20 meter, and the velocity is 3.5 meters per second and theta equal to 45 degree. We calculate the area of the pipe. Area, the inlet and the outlet, they are equal. A1 equal to A2 equal to pi by 4 d square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. And the discharge Q equal to area into velocity, 0.07065 into 3.5 equal to 0.247 meter cube per second. And the pressure P1 equal to P2 equal to rho gh. So rho gh is 1009.81 and the head equal to 20 meter. So 196,200 newtons per meter square is the pressure in the pipeline. And this is the pipe, the bend pipe. The diameter is equal, the force horizontal. So inlet is horizontal and the outlet we have some component. Velocity components are shown here. V2 is the velocity, V2 cos 45 is the horizontal component, V2 sin 45 is the vertical component. Similarly, P1 A1 is the force acting vertically, P1 A1 sin 45 and P1 A1 cos 45, they are the forces. And the V1x equal to V1 equal to 3.5 meters per second, V1y equal to 0, P1 A1x equal to P1 A1 which is 196,200 into 0.07065. Which is 13,861.53 Newton, P1A1Y equal to 0. And V2X equal to V2 cos 45, which is 3.5 into cos 45 equal to 2.47 meters per second. V2Y is also V2 sin 45, which is again 3.5 into sin 45 equal to again 2.47 meters per second. So P2A2X equal to minus P2A2 cos 45 minus of 196,200 into 0.07065 into cos 45 equal to minus 9,801.6 Newton. And the P2A2 at the Y direction minus P2A2 sin 45 minus of 196,200 into 0.07065 into sin 45 equal to minus 9,801.6. So cos 45, sin 45 values are equal. That is why we are getting equal value in the X and the Y directions. And again, the force in the x direction, referring to the diagram once again, force in the x direction Fx equal to rho q into V1x minus V2x plus P1A1x plus P2A2x. So substituting 1000 into 2.47 into 3.5 minus 2.47 plus 13861.53 minus 9801.6 equal to 4314.34 Newton. And force in the y direction Fy equal to rho q into V1y minus V2y plus P1A1 y at the y direction plus P2A2 at the y direction. So substituting numerical values, FY equal to 1000 into 2.47 into 0 minus 2.47 plus 0 minus 9801.6, which is minus 10,411.69. So the resultant force equal to F equal to Fx square plus FY square 4314.34 plus minus of 10,411.69 whole square equal to 11,270 Newton. And the angle made by the resultant force theta equal to tan inverse of FY by F6, FY by Fx, which is tan inverse of 10,411.69 divided by 4,314.34, which is 67.49 degrees. Next problem, the diameter of the pipe bend is 0.3 meter at inlet and 0.2 meter at the outlet, and the flow is turned through 135 degree in the vertical plane. The axis at the inlet make an angle of 50 degree to the horizontal plane, and the center of the outlet section is 1 meter above the center of the inlet section. The total volume of the fluid contained in the bend is 0.12 meter cube. So due to loss of energy between inlet and the outlet, 0.2 meter head is lost. Calculate the magnitude and direction of the force exerted by the on the bend by water flowing through the through it, and at the 230 lps when the inlet pressure is 150.78 kilometers per meter square. And this question is from May 2019 question paper. And we are given D1 diameter of the inlet 0.35 meter, at the outlet D2 equal to 0.2 meter, head loss equal to 0.2 meter, discharge equal to 0.23 meter cube per second, pressure the inlet is 150.78 kilometers per meter square. So we calculate the area of the pipe at the inlet and the outlet. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.35 square equal to 0.0962 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 d2 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. And we calculate the velocity at the inlet and the outlet. V1 equal to q by A1, 0.23 divided by 0.0962 equal to 2.39 meters per second. And V2 equal to q by A2, which is 0.23 divided by 0.0314 equal to 7.32 meters per second. Applying the Bernoulli's equation between the sections 1 and 2, P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus HF. HF is the head loss due to friction. 150.78 10 power 3 divided by 1000 into 9.81 plus V1 equal to 2.39 square divided by 2 into 9.81. We take Z1 equal to 0. So Z2 is 1 meter above Z1. So we take reference point Z1 equal to 0 and Z2 equal to 1 meter. So, equal to P2 by 1000 into 9.81 plus 7.32 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus 1. HF equal to 0.2. So we calculate the pressure at the outlet of the pipe, which is 115,081 newtons per meter square. Now, this is the pipe bend. So, inlet section, which is 50 degree incline to the horizontal plane, and the outlet section, which is 45 degree with respect to the horizontal plane, but through the vertical plane, it is 135 degree from the vertical plane. So, subtracting 90 degree, so it is 45 degree inclined to the horizontal plane, above the horizontal plane, and the inlet of the pipe is 50 degree inclined. And we have the velocity vector, V1 is the velocity at the inlet, V1 sin 50 is the vertical component, V1 cos 50 is the horizontal component. Similarly, at the outlet, V2 is the velocity here, V2 sin 45 is the vertical component, V2 cos 45 is the horizontal component. So, calculating the forces, various forces at inlet, V1x equal to V1 cos 50, 2.39 into cos 50 equal to 1.54 meters per second, and V1y equal to V1 sin 50, which is 2.39 into sin 50 equal to 1.83 meters per second. P1A1x equal to P1A1 cos 50, which is 150,780 into 0.0962 into cos 50 equal to 9,323.66 newton. P1A1 at y, in the y direction, P1A1 to sin 50, 150,780 into 0.0962 into sin 50 equal to 11,111.5 newton. These are all the forces and velocity be at the inlet of the pipe bend. Similarly, at the outlet of the pipe bend, so V2x equal to V2 cos 45, 7.32 cos 45 equal to 5.176 meters per second, V2y equal to V2 sin 45, 7.32 into sin 45 equal to 5.176 meters per second. And similarly, the force, pressure force P2A2x, x direction, minus P2A2 cos 45, minus 115,081 into 0.0314 into cos 45 equal to minus 2555.16 newton. Similarly, in the y direction, P2A2y equal to minus P2A2 sin 45, which is again 115,081 into 0.0314 into sin 45 equal to minus of 2555.16 newton. Now, calculating the force in the x direction, the force in the x direction, force in the y direction, resultant force and the angle made by the resultant force. So the force in the x direction, Fx equal to rho q into v1x minus v2x plus p1a1 x direction and p2a2 in the x direction. Substituting 1000 into 0.23 into 1.54 minus 5.176 plus 9323.66 minus 2555.16 equal to 5932.22 newton. And the force in the y direction, Fy into Fy equal to rho q into v1y minus v2y plus pressure force p1a1y plus p2a2y. So calculating substitute unit value is 1000 into 0.23 into 1.83 minus 5.176 into 11111.5 minus 2555.16 equal to 7786.76 newton. Resultant force F equal to Fx square plus Fy square. So 5932.22 square plus 7786.76 square equal to 9789 newton. The angle made by the resultant force theta equal to tan inverse of Fy divided by Fx, which is tan inverse of 7786.76 divided by 5932.22 equal to 52.7 degrees. Example number 19 from November 2010 question paper. Determine the velocity of the jet directed at the 40 degree to the horizontal to clear 6 meter height at a distance of 20 meter. Also determine the maximum height this jet will clear and the total horizontal travel. What will be the horizontal distance at which the jet will be again at the 6 meter height? So this is the nozzle. So a jet is ejected from the nozzle at an angle theta. So theta equal to 40 degree and y is the height measured 6 meter at a distance x equal to 20 meter. Now vertical distance traveled by the liquid particle. So y equal to x into tan theta minus g x square by 2 u square into secant square theta. Substituting all the values, y is given as 6, x is given as 20 meter. Tan 40, angle is tan 40, g 9.81, x square 20 square divided by 2 u square, u is the unknown, velocity is unknown, into secant square 40. So calculating velocity u equal to 17.6 meters per second. And the maximum height attained by the jet sc equal to u square sin square theta divided by 2g. So 17.6 square into sin square 40 divided by 2 into 9.81 equal to 6.52 meter. And the horizontal range of the jet x star equal to u square by 2g into sin 2 theta, which is 17.6 square divided by 2 into 9.81 into sin 2 into 40 equal to 15.54 meter. So these are all the velocity. Velocity is calculated as 17.6 meter square meter per second. Yes, the maximum height equal to 6.52 meter and the horizontal range is 15.54 meter. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to it. You have the fluid mechanics and machinery book. So in which you may find additional problems in the fluid dynamics. You can refer to it. I upload the all video lectures in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for the better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in another video lecture on the fluid mechanics and machines. Until then, bye bye.